Welcome to the World of Warcraft Survival Guide for Visions of N'Zoth, the latest content update for Battle for Azeroth. In this video, we'll take a look at the new features and changes coming with it. With the defeat of Queen Ashara, the old god N'Zoth was freed from his prison. Now, he's unleashing his shadowy forces upon Azeroth. We'll need some awesome gear and new allied races to battle against the Void. Two new allied races will be available to play in Visions of N'Zoth, the resourceful Volpera and industrious Mechanomes. As with other allied races, unlocking each race will reward you with a unique mount, and leveling a new Volpera or Mechanome from 20 to 110 will earn you a special Heritage Armor transmogrification set. Horde players can unlock Volpera by completing the Vol'Dun level-up storyline and reaching Exalted with the Vol'Dunai. Alliance players who are exalted with the Rust Bolt Resistance and have completed the Mechagon storyline can embark on a questline to create a Mechanome of their very own. Level 120 players will see the overwhelming might of the Old Gods firsthand in new assaults on Titan facilities in either Uldum or the Vale of Eternal Blossoms. Players must drive back N'Zoth's minions by completing objectives in the area, including defeating enemies and rares, looting treasures, and participating in events. After making some progress, players will go up against the lieutenant leading the enemy's forces. Once victorious, you'll be rewarded with a powerful piece of equipment and a vessel of horrific visions, a key that gives you access to a new feature, Horrific Visions. Horrific Visions are instance content for 1 to 5 players that subject you to N'Zoth's twisted future for Orgrimmar and Stormwind. While exploring a Horrific Vision, your sanity will be under constant attack, increasing difficulty and forcing you to leave before you're consumed by insanity. Each time you undergo a Horrific Vision, you'll leave with more knowledge and fragments of N'Zoth's corruption. Take these to Mother and Magni in Silithus to strengthen your defenses and earn new tools, which will allow you to delve deeper into N'Zoth's Horrific Visions and earn greater rewards. Players seeking the next echelon of rewards and challenges can adventure into bonus areas of Horrific Visions to discover faceless masks. Wearing these masks raises the difficulty level of Horrific Visions and unlocks access to stronger items. To combat N'Zoth's corruption, Rathion will return and work with players to craft a legendary cloak. This upgradable legendary starts at rank 1 at item level 470. With subsequent ranks increasing its power and adding other unique effects. It will enable players to venture deeper and deeper into Horrific Visions, earning greater rewards and unlocking more of the mysteries behind N'Zoth's power. This cloak may also come in handy when you face off against N'Zoth himself in the upcoming raid. Also in Visions of N'Zoth, you'll find gear with a new stat called Corruption. Cursed by N'Zoth, corrupted items offer truly exceptional power. For a price. As you don more corrupted gear, the corruption will begin to affect you in increasingly deadly ways. At low corruption levels, you may be slowed periodically when taking damage, while at higher corruption levels, evil forces from the Void may come for you at any moment. Deciding how much corruption to take on is a delicate balancing act, which can be mitigated with your new legendary cloak and new essences. By donning these powerful items, you can counter negative side effects and reap the benefits of N'Zoth's might without all of the downsides. Players can now unlock a new minor slot on their Heart of Azeroth at level 75, along with periodic increases to stamina up to level 80. The Heart of Azeroth can be leveled beyond 80, granting it increased item level and slight stat increases. New essences can be found in assaults on Uldum and Vale of Eternal Blossoms, delving into Horrific Visions, and the Nyalotha Raid. Visions of N'Zoth also brings with it a visual update and redesign for the Deepwind Gorge battleground. Inspired by Arathi Basin, the new Deepwind Gorge has 5 capture points for teams to battle over. Of course, there's so much more coming with Visions of N'Zoth, including new storyline quests to confront N'Zoth and his armies and navigate a peace treaty between the Alliance and Horde. You'll also be able to earn Goblin and Worgen Heritage Armor, and players who have pre-purchased Shadowlands will be able to create Death Knights of unlocked allied races and Pandaren. We'll also see a rebuilt auction house, an arcade addition to the Darkmoon Fair, and new profession recipes. And that's just the beginning. We'll meet you here again to discuss the start of Season 4 of PvP and Mythic Keystone Dungeons, the Darkshore Heroic Warfront, and of course, the new 12-boss raid, Nyalotha, the Waking City. Keep an eye on worldofwarcraft.com for more details on upcoming content. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the front lines.